The views and opinions expressed on Detroit Wants to Know with Steve Hood are not those of WADL TV 38 or Adele Broadcasting Corporation.
People moving out, people moving in. Why? Because of the color of the skin.
Run, 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 but you sure can't hide.
To teacher, segregation, determination, demonstration, integration, aggravation, diminution, obligation to my nation.
Welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. You're watching TV 38 WADL. This week, Mayor Bing introduced his financial stability agreement. All right, let's cut to the chase, ladies and gentlemen. Mayor Bing just made himself emergency financial manager. Okay, this can't be allowed to happen. Let's forget the unconstitutionality of Public Act 4 for a second. Let's just talk about his management. All right, $71 million in DHS money, gone. $20 million of demolition money, not used. Home weatherization funds, not used, mismanaged. Planning and development, you've got community development block grants have mushroomed to $70 million. I don't know how many times I have to say it, this guy is not running the city. Now, all at the same time that we're hearing this, the emergency financial manager law is taking hits all over the place. An Ingham County judge has said that the city of Detroit cannot sign a consent agreement until he actually rules on whether the financial review team met outside of the Public Meetings Act. That's first, but citing his ruling as precedent, a Genesee County judge just removed the emergency financial manager and replaced them with the mayor and city council who actually asked for the emergency financial manager. Then you've got 200,000 signatures that have been turned in to overturn the emergency financial manager law. Now, so this law is in big jeopardy. But don't forget the constitutional litigation that's going on. So while all this is happening, ladies and gentlemen, the city of Detroit is in dire straits. Right now, Ernst & Young projects that they had a $42 million cash balance back in March. By April, that cash balance is going to be down to $2.5 million. By May, that cash balance is going to be a negative $9.5 million. And by the end of the fiscal year, it's going to be a whopping $48 million. Ladies and gentlemen, the city of Detroit is in dire straits. Payless paydays are on the way. But while that's happening, I've got my main man, Reverend D. Alexander Bullock from Operation Push, that's doing these surprise attacks, these surprise marches. You're no longer announcing it. Governor Schneider, we're coming to march on your house. So tell us, where's the next march? No, before you do that, why march? Why march when you got all this attacking Public Act 4?
Well, we march because we don't have the kind of sponsorship to have a great TV show like Detroit Wants to Know.
Thank you. Say it loud. I'm Steve and I'm proud.
Steve Hood has a great TV show, Detroit Wants to Know, and he uses that show as a platform to raise questions. Well, marches are a way to do two things, really. Educate the public and then mobilize the base. We have seen in these 12 days or the commencement of the 12 days of action, our crowd grow from 12 to 200. Now, those 200 people are not just anti-Public Act 4. Those 200 people are pro-Detroit, 200 and growing. We met with ministers, with the AME pastors on yesterday. We're meeting with the AME Zion pastors today. And so we are using action as a way of getting people involved and engaged. And the same momentum that we built around the petition campaign to repeal PA4 is the same momentum we're going to use to fight for the Department of Human Services. It's to fight against the overly privatization of city departments and to fight for the restructuring of Detroit.
Okay. This week, Moody's downgraded the city's bond rating.
Right.
Okay. It's now junk bonds. All right. It's now junk bonds.
That's right.
What, if not Public Act 4, if not emergency manager, then what? What is your solution? You can't march without a solution.
Well, there are a number of solutions, and of course, we have said both in from the short to the medium to the long term, this whole conversation is misplaced. You can't talk about revitalizing Detroit or urban cities in Michigan like Benton Harbor, like Flint, like Saginaw, all of them facing the same issues, without talking about a residency requirement for city workers, without talking about insurance apartheid,
without talking about foreclosures, the very banks.
You're obfuscating
the situation.
No, the very
you
banks
got a city that's
have
about
90,
to issue.
Foreclosures in Detroit, you've got a city that's about to issue bounced checks.
The city's going to get the $137 million. No, you only think they are.
Let me tell you,
if you look at a businessman, which Governor Schneider is, do you really think he's going to throw $137, let alone the $200 million that he has said, that Andy Dillon has said the state owes us, towards Mayor Bing, when he even sees that Mayor Bing can't manage? His deputy treasurer said, we are unsure about Mayor Bing's ability to manage. So that, let me tell you, that $137 million without a major upheaval isn't going to come. Now, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to have you back here in 2 weeks.
Okay.
I promise you. Wherever we are in two weeks, because
yes,
I think we're going to go on a location.
Yes, sir.
Wherever we are, I'm going to have you back. I want a solution.
Okay.
And I want a solution that does not obfuscate the issue. Okay, the issue is Detroit is about to be broke. Detroit is about to bounce people's
checks. Steve, let me say this.
Say it quickly.
Andy Dillon was at the Council of Baptist Pastors yesterday.
Yes.
And he completely contradicted what you just said. He said, I completely agree that Mayor Dave Bing can run the city and the state
so
is going to send the money.
Then what needs to happen is he needs to get with his own people because they're saying something different. All right?
All right.
And you know what? I'd behave in front of the Council of Baptist Pastors too.
I can't wait to come back.
Daddy ain't no joke. This is Steve Hood. We'll be right back.